First thing that comes to mind is bibimbap. It's a Korean traditional food. I think the history of it goes back to in king's houses, there would be all the servants would make all this amazing food for the king and his family, and then the leftovers they would just mix it up and just in this big pot and just eat it, and that was called bibimbap. Bibi, that means to mix, and pap is just food or rice, and so bibimbap means mixed food or mixed rice. So basically, that's the history of it. But now it's like kind of it's part of our culture, so we eat it on a regular basis. And basically what it is you prepare all these different vegetables, and you prepare this meat, you prepare eggs, and you mix it all up with this amazing hot pepper paste sauce, and then with some sesame oil, and then you mix it all up and you eat it, and it's amazing. The reason I like it so much is not only because of the taste, but because how healthy it is. I mean, there's so much, like you get this shigimchi, which is like this green, very verdant kind of vegetable. You get all these different, like hongnamul, which is sprouts, bean sprouts. You could put mushrooms in, you could put like turnips in, and you just put all kinds of vegetables in there and just mix it all up. And so all the different, you just feel like you're eating the good of the land, like the creations of God that He made for us. And I guess comparing that to American food, not to be offensive in any way, but what I've noticed is that a lot of the American food, at least here, is mostly deals with bread, cheese, meat, and vegetables. Is kind of like a little bit, you just put in a little bit of vegetables, but the big focus is on the meat and the potatoes and the bread, and which is still great. I mean, it tastes great, but after eating American food, I always feel very like stuffed, But Korean food, it's very like if you eat it, like it's very, there's so many different diversities of flavors and textures and nutrients. I just feel very whole. I think that's partly because I am Korean, so my food, me, like it goes well. Yeah, that's the kind of the difference between Korean food and American food. And of course, American food, like you can eat healthy as well. Like, there are lots of salads and such. Korean food, we kind of pride ourselves in the fact that, oh, we have a 5,000-year history. I don't know how true that is. I mean, it goes back a long time, but I don't know if it goes back 5,000 years. Maybe like 2 or 3,000 years. Our history is there, but it's a country that has a very well-developed tradition of food. So there are all kinds of food. Another food, great food, is naengmyeon, which is a cold noodle dish, but they put in half an egg, they put in these Asian pears, and what's pei? I don't know what it is in English. Is it like a turnip or a radish? It's either one of the two, but they put in those things. And so if you kind of analyze their dish, the naengmyeon dish, it's very well balanced, because you put in vinegar and mustard, so that's part of it. And so the vinegar is acidic, and so to counterbalance that, you have the egg yolk. And so you eat the egg first, coat your esophagus, your stomach, with this coating of this egg yolk, and then you eat the acidic but tasty noodles with the radish to help you digest the food. And so if you kind of analyze Korean food, it's very well thought out, it seems. It's very You can tell I have a lot of pride in Korean food. What else is there? Korean barbecue. Americans love Korean barbecue because of the particular sauce, I think. It's like the soy sauce mixed with garlic, and there's a taste of sesame in there. And so meat, when it's marinated in that sauce, it's amazing. Have you had Korean barbecue before? No? Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay, you have to have Korean barbecue. 불고기, LA 갈비, 돼지 갈비, 떡 갈비. Oh my gosh. Yeah, 갈비 is huge. So if you ever go to a Korean restaurant, make sure to order a 갈비 or 불고기. Oh, Korean food has so much, like so many different soups and stews, like doenjang jjigae, kimchi jjigae, budae jjigae, what else is there? We have all this amazing street food like tteokbokki, that's like a rice cake thing with fish cakes. That sounds bad in English, but it's very good. Fish cakes and this hot, spicy sauce. Korean food is spicy in general, like compared to American food. There's a lot more flair to it. And so if you live in America, or if your taste buds acclimate to American food, and then you eat try Korean food, like it can be very spicy. But Koreans like don't think it's spicy. They don't really recognize that it's spicy because that's just kind of their diet. Yeah, also funny thing about Korea, different parts, even though it's such a small country, there's so much diversity in Korea, because depending on which province you're from, you'll speak a different accent and you'll eat different kinds of food. Like some provinces will eat, they're famous for their food that's very spicy and salty, even on Korean standards. And they taste very good. Then there are some, like this past winter, I went to Korea, into a province where I think they were famous for their tofu. Like they would make tofu, like on the spot, or the night before, and then they would serve it to you. And like the tofu, you think tofu is white, right? Well, this tofu, like they have all kinds of tofu. Like they have black tofu, they have green tofu, like some of the tofu is even pink. Like depending on the beans that you use, like you can get different kinds of colors of tofu, and obviously there are different kinds of nutrients, and it tastes different too. And so eating that, all the different kinds of tofu, was just divine.